Okay, welcome back, guys. Part two, 5K Naniwa. It's actually the 5K Naniwa Goose and Craig Yaki. Bit of slurry on the fresh bit of tape on the razor. I'm just going to refine those 3K scratches. So I'm going to start off with some R strokes and get this refined even further for the next stone after that. So let's go, let's do that. Using a little bit of pressure. So you can see how this clogs up compared to the pro stone, but still a nice stone, the 5K Naniwa Gookin. When I say Naniwa Gookin Kagiaki, it is a super stone, but it's just a newer version. 20mm thick these are as well, which is a lot better. Don't get the warping problems you get with the 10mm thick ones. And they come in this little plastic container as well, so. Some of that slurry on there. The slurry just speeds the stone up a little bit. I like working with the slurry on there anyway. Right, let's check that edge. Even on the 5K, that's picking up here. Right, let's just check this bevel. A little bit more polished. Gonna do a few more strokes on here. So this is the 5K, it's just refining those 3K scratches. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go straight from this stone here, and I'm going to miss the 8k out, and I'm going to go straight to the Naniwa 10k, which can be done. That's done. Right, I'm just going to get my 10k back in a sec. To generate some slurry on this 10k. Back again. Right, 10k slurry on that edge. What I'm going to do, I'm going to just lightly dull that edge. And I'm going to bring that back. On this 10k. Circles. So I just took that edge off there. I'm going to bring that back on this 10k. I think Yorick from Karat goes from something like a worn out 1k diamond plate, I'm sure he's talking about, or a 400 even, and he goes straight to the 10k. So it can be done easy. Let's see if we can slice this tomato quite easy. Yeah, so that's brought that back on that 10k. Just going to work a little bit longer on here. It's picking up here, lovely that is. That's definitely, I'm going to rinse this stone, finish on water, 1 second.
Okay.
Right, so we've just got plain water on here now, a few strokes on here to polish this edge up. Just on clear water. Finish on this stone. Part three is going to be the finishing stone. Normally I'd go Jane out, slurry to water. I could go black Arkansas stone from here. I could even go corticule just to tame it down a little bit. Even chromium oxide. Any choice of your favourite finisher could be used on this stone. I've even got a little laloon. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to shave straight off this 10k in my next video, or at some point, and then I'm going to use the finisher in the next video, which will be my Japanese natural stone. And I'll be using slurry to water and finishing on the loom strop. I'll be finishing on the loom strop after this stone. No linen, just leather. Definitely shave ready. How comfortable? Should be comfortable. Synthetics can be a little bit harsh, but I have heard a lot of people say that, I think on the German forums, that they don't go no higher than a 10k, and they think 10k naniwa is better than the 12k. I've tried both and I'm not really, it's hard to separate them, but that is pinging here, trust me. Off above the skin level there. I'm just going to check this edge under the little microscope. Oh yeah, it's like a bloody, like a mirror that is. Wow, that's a good polishing stone. That absolutely like a mirror. What's one thing with synthetics you do get? There's a real mirror finish. Right, I'll catch you guys for the next video. Take care for now, bye.